And it's time now for our weekly feature on Action 7 News Live this morning called Chat with the Chief. Action 7 News anchor Doug Fernandez talks with APD Chief Ray Schultz about issues in his department and concerns from you, the viewer. Today's topic, how decisions are made when you call police well before you see an officer at your door.
APD's Emergency Operations Center. Just about every call to police comes in here.
When someone calls 911, 242 cops, this is where all the calls are vetted into. So this is staffed all the time, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year.
Dispatchers take the call and do an assessment of its severity and its need for service.
Our goal is to try to answer all 911 calls within 10 seconds. And then 242 cops calls within 30 seconds.
And this board tracks the success of reaching those goals.
The busiest time for us are Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. But that can all change with just a moment's notice.
Like when there is a major emergency like a traffic pileup or a multiple shooting.
Because of cell phones, and now any major event has the ability to generate hundreds of calls into this center.
Calls that can take a while to answer, so be patient.
If someone does call, though, what we want people to do is not hang up. Because very often people get frustrated, they call, and because we have a large influx in the number of calls coming in, it's going to take more than the average number of rings before we're going to answer it.
Calls into the Emergency Operations Center are prioritized into three categories. A priority one call is when the crime is ongoing and someone's life could be in danger. And for those,
we hope to have an officer on scene in those calls between 3 and 6 minutes.
Priority two or three calls can get a response time of 20 minutes or more. And APD tries to always have officers available should a priority one call come in. While these dispatchers don't wear a badge or carry a gun, their decisions can also mean the difference between life or death. So they receive a lot of training, both in the classroom and on the job.
Even after they graduate to a council, there's training that goes on throughout the employee's career. Training never stops.
Doug Fernandez, KOAT Action 7 News, live this morning.